The authors Ruwanmali PAS, Dissanayake WDN, to present their paper on balance, hand grip strength, and risk of falling in children with visual impairment, which will be presented by Ruwanmali PAS. Over to you.
Good afternoon. I'm Sachin Ruwanmali, student from University of Colombo, Faculty of Medicine, University of Colombo. My research is balance, hand grip strength, and risk of falling in children with visual impairments. Introduction. Balance is maintained by three major factors. They are vision, proprioception, and vestibular system. So if someone being with impaired vision, it may interrupt their balance process. Then hand grip strength. Almost always, people with visual impairments are using light touching. So because they get more information, their tactiles, by their tactile sensation. Previous studies have proved prolonged experience of light touching causes their changing in muscle properties and muscle strength. As well as previous studies have confirmed decreased balance and decreased hand grip strength cause the higher risk of falling. General objective is to compare balance, hand grip strength, and risk of falling between children with visual impairments and sighted children. Literature review. Globally, 2.2 billion people have visual impairments and blindness. The visual system provides information regarding mainly three parts. They are position of the head related to the environment, orientation of the head, maintained level of the gaze, and the direction and speed of the head movement. The prolonged experience of the light touching can cause changes in muscle properties, and repeated overloaded wrist position cause the reduction of muscle strength. Children with visual impairments are weaker in hand grasping activities, as well as loss of visual information causes poor balance and decrease in hand grip strength, leading to higher risk of falling. Justification. The most of studies have been done for visually impaired elders regarding balance and risk of falling, but fewer for regarding hand grip strength. But children have higher physical activity level and less experience to adapt their own life than elders. Therefore, conducting my study for children is very important. Balance, hand grip strength are important to carry out day-to-day activities and to prevent falls, which is important to maintain independent lives with self-confidence. Methodology. I conducted my research as an analytical cross-sectional study. I recruited 45 visually impaired children from deaf and blind school and 45 sighted children from Molto Mahavidyalaya according to systematic randomization. Their age range was 11 to 18. It was very wide age range because I divided them into three age groups as 11 to 13, 13 to 15, and 15 to 18. Their visual acuity was 12/6 to 0 for visually impaired children, and it was above 6/6 for visual sighted children. I used Snellen chart for measuring visual acuity, and I used balance subtest of BERT 2 scale for measuring balance, and handheld dynamometer used for the measuring hand grip strength, and interview administered questionnaire for used for the risk measuring risk of falling. Results. These two graphs show tables show distribution of social demographic and physical characteristics among study sample. The first graph comparison of balance. The first graph shows how they got a score for all tasks of the BERT 2 scale. And second, according to the second graph, children with visual impairments have lower balance than sighted children. Comparison of hand grip strength. Both lower and both left and right hand grip strength were lowered in children with visual impairment than sighted children. Comparison of risk of falling. Children with visual impairments have higher risk of falling than sighted children. According to this graph. Discussion. Children with visual impairments have poor balance parameters and lower hand grip strength and a higher risk of falling compared to normal sighted peers. So, balance training program, physical fitness improvement programs, including muscle strengthening exercises, would be very beneficial to children with visual impairments, especially in their schools. Thank you.
Floor is open for discussion.
falls of these two groups, the falling of children, the incidence of falls in the two groups.
Sorry?
Actual the incidence of falls in these two group of children, the visually impaired children and the normal children.
I measured risk of falling by questionnaire. That questionnaire was included their previous falls and the fear of falling and history of falling, like this.
I think related to that, now sighted children and visually impaired children, their perceptions of falling and the risks and that they perceive and the events may be different. So did you just accommodate for that in the questionnaire that you made?
Yeah, I included them, and especially some, there were some special points regarding it. They were related to both groups, some most of activities.
How are you going to use this in actual practice?
Yes, it's very important if we can arranging physical training programs as well aerobic exercise. I there was a, it's my specific objective that I analyzed the relationship between the BMI value and the balance. So I found the higher children with higher BMI value have less balance. So the arranging physical fitness training program, including muscle strengthening, balance improvement program, and as well as aerobic exercises programs, are very important to children with visual impairments.
Does the muscle strength affect the lower limbs?
Sorry?
Is it only the upper limbs? The lower limbs are also affected?
According to literature review, I found there's in children with visual impairments have lower strength in lower limb muscles.
Okay. Thank you.